I had gotten mascara in my hair. And normally you'll just take your finger and pull the mascara off your hair. When I did that, I had a clump of hair in my hand. So Jeff, Emily, and I, we went to the backyard. I sat in a chair and he shaved my hair. And Emily was out there. She took the picture so that we would have that moment captured, because I felt like that was a story to share with other people.
He kissed her head and he said, "I love you and you're beautiful." He loves her so much.
He was my friend, he was my caretaker, and
he loves me probably more than I deserve. And I know that people worried about me, and I did have the disease, but it doesn't just impact the person with the disease. It affects the whole family.
If you ever need someone to make you smile, hold your hand and get you through the hardest times. I would run out, fly out, travel all night, do anything just to be by your side and tell you
hair falling out. At first I thought that would really bother me a lot. I was not as bothered by the loss of my hair. I was really wanting to keep my eyebrows and my eyelashes. And I did until the very last treatment.
Usually when you hear people that are going through cancer, you automatically think like, oh, they're gonna die. Like, that's just what you think.
Of course, in the beginning, when you're told and you're kind of not sure about what your future holds, you're definitely concerned about, you know, leaving your husband, leaving your mother, leaving your children. That was a moment for me, but I said, I'm going to deal with this today, and then I'm gonna put my feet on the ground. I'm gonna fight this, I'm gonna win this. It's not gonna define who I am.
You know I'm gonna be there when you're feeling down. Just call on me, I'll always help you out. It could be something, it could be some small, something really stupid, don't matter at all. It's gonna be just fine. Oh, oh, everything is gonna be alright.
I definitely believe that she's my role model more than ever, and I really see how strong she is to have gone through all this.
It's been a learning experience for her, and she's been able to, I think, grow up through this in a way that is a positive for her.
It made a big impact on my life. It made me see the world as, like, not to take it for granted, just be thankful for everything you have.
I've always been a positive person and live my life the right way. But I think now, even more so, to make every moment count, every second of every day, there will not be a moment that I'm not thankful for the love that I have for my family and friends. People face difficulties and hard decisions every single day, but you have to choose joy, you have to choose love, and you have to choose to be happy. And that's my advice for everyone.